Thank you so much for staying with us, everyone. One event everyone is waiting and looking out for, of course. When we talk about Ondo governorship election, is the televised debate of the governorship election in Ondo, which is slated for Monday, the 21st of November 2016. Channels Television will be live with the top four candidates in the race. Those are some of those people that you've chosen by yourselves in a survey that we sent out with our partners, Enough is Enough Nigeria, and the Policy and Legal Advocacy Center, on who do you think should be the top four candidates that should contest in the race. And so we have four of them from the PDP, APC, the SDP, and the AD. Those candidates will take center stage on Monday, 7 p.m. right here on Channels Television. So look out for that, the engaging conversations that will ensue on that day. Let's begin now with some of the issues that is on hands today. The Court of Appeal case on the candidacy of the People's Democratic Party took a dramatic twist earlier today, with the Court of Appeal adjourning the judgment and the PDP tussle over the candidacy indefinitely. The judgment slated for delivery was put off by Justice Ibrahim Solawa following a motion filed at the Supreme Court by the Senator Limadu Sharif-led faction of the PDP asking the appeal court panel to hand off the matter. And the motion, factional chairman of the party in Ondo said Prince Biyi Okporoye accused a three-man panel of bias and prayed the Supreme Court to restrain the justices from further proceedings in the appeals. The motion served in the panel about 7:30 p.m. last night alleged that the three justices had betrayed their oath of office with the way the appeals were being handled and that they have refused to be bound by their own earlier orders. The three justices, Justice Ibrahim Solawa, Inatus Igwe Hagube, and Judge Mbaba, were joined as parties in the suit. Justice Solawa, who announced the receipt of the motion, described the move as politically motivated and diabolical. He added that the panel was put in place on a rescue mission when the Justice Juma Isanke-led panel threw in the towel following accusations of bias and bribery. The case, he said, will stand there, John, pending the decision of the Apex Court. Meanwhile, the Senator McCarthy-led PDP is not happy with the outcome. And these are some of the thoughts of the lawyers after that judgment earlier today.
Just want to say that this is a very sad, tragic, and most unfortunate development. The reality is that everything is now crystal clear that the respondents who had all along done everything to ensure that the speedy and expeditious hearing and determination of the appeals were truncated have succeeded. So the tragedy here is that the judiciary of this country is on trial. And it is the justice of this situation, it is the justice of the cases that has been the very worst for it. The reality is very clear to any discerning mind that the respondents were all along minded to scuttle, to truncate, to frustrate the hearing of their peace. Unfortunately, they have succeeded in doing that for now. But it is hopeful that by the grace of God Almighty, we will get the matter to be decided one way or the other at the Supreme Court, and God willing, justice, and I want to emphasize justice, shall still prevail.
The rules provide that once an appeal has been entered, the condition is that has the appeal been entered? Once an appeal is entered, what happens is that the court below must hands off the matter and wait for the decision of the upper court before it can take any decision. And that is exactly what they have done today. So you people that don't understand the law, they don't understand the judiciary, they think it's being used or abused. But no, the law is fair to all. The law is impartial. The law is actually blind. It doesn't see, it doesn't favor.
Interesting times. When lawyers speak like this, people who know the law He gets a lot of us who are not lawyers confused, including you, perhaps, who do not understand what law and the Constitution of Nigeria is all about. Some of this decision in the courtroom is really affecting what will happen on the field on election day. But November 26 is on the minds of many people. The candidates of PDP, well, with the Senator McCarthy faction, Mr. Yetayo Jegede himself, a senior advocate of Nigeria, is not happy with this. But then his side has said they will wait and see what happens at the Senate. Well, this is what Mr. Jegede is saying after that judgment. He has called for calm over the Court of Appeal decision. He said, I call on our supporters to remain calm and not be weighed down by the latest developments, which I believe should only strengthen our resolve in ensuring that despite all contrivances and manipulations, we will contest and win the November 26, 2016 governorship election. My team of lawyers are working assiduously to ensure that this grave injustice again to subvert my mandate through several devious means of propaganda, blackmail, and unprecedented assault against the judiciary is corrected using available legal means. Well, end of quote. Those are the thoughts of Mr. Yetayo Jegede calling for calm in this matter. But again, the PDP is asking that this case be this election in Ondo State be postponed. The Senator McCarthy-led PDP is not happy at all, and the outcome of the looming and clear indication that Mr. Yetayo Jegede's chances of running in the race might be dashed. The spokesperson of the Senator McCarthy-led caretaker committee of the party, Prince Dayo Adeyeye, is asking INEC to postpone the exercise, and these are his reasons.
And respondents to frustrate this case all along. And we have all also come to court every day since this matter started. So we have seen the uncommon courage demonstrated by the panel of judges in doing having a speedy dispensation of justice. Because, as we all know, the maxim, justice delayed is justice denied. People say the judiciary is the last hope of the common man. If you don't allow the judiciary to be that last hope of the common man will take the law into his own hands. We are treading on a dangerous path in this country. If we do not allow the judiciary to perform their functions, if we try to manipulate the judiciary in any way, if we try to suppress the judiciary in any way, people will begin to take the laws into their hands, and anarchy will reign and reign supreme in Nigeria. And God forbid, when that day happens, it will consume those who are behind all these matters. I want to say that in the case of Odo election, the only option left now is for INEC to postpone this election by a minimum of at least 2 to 3 weeks. The election must be postponed. We, PDP, we are calling on INEC to postpone the election by a minimum of 2 to 3 weeks. They did so in Edo where there was no problem. In Ondo State, there is major problem. And we are calling on the president, we are calling on INEC, on all those who are responsible, to be alive to that responsibility, to take this matter seriously and postpone the Odo election by at least 2 or 3 weeks, so that the Supreme Court can be given the opportunity to dispense with this matter once and for all.